Hey, what's up? It's Ford Thurston, and welcome to Ghetto Blues number 8. We're in the key of A, A blues, but we're working on the 4 chord, 5th fret, A string, 7th fret, D, 5th fret, G, 7th fret, B string, finishing off with the high E. And today, I'm plugged back in. Am I too loud, sweetheart? Oh, yes. There we go. So, we'll try to do this at normal hours rather than 3 in the morning. Someone said I was stoned in my last video. Do I look like I'm stoned? So, you know, with that chord, you know, if you're coming out of the blues, it's that 4 chord, right? Play the notes right in the chord. They're right. All I did was, the trick was I ended on the major 3rd, which is an F sharp, right? Remember in the last lesson, I showed you the, I showed you the Mixolydian scale. D chord, right? Along with the flat 7, okay? And the 5th. Very colorful, cool notes, right? So, for practice reasons, just take a D chord and make a loop. It doesn't have to be even a groove. Just play it, you know? Just focus like. Mixing the notes from that chord along with that last lesson scale. Right? The idea is that, you know, mixing that major together with minor, looking at the chord and knowing, hey, this is where all my notes are. Put some minor. G, D, and A, breaking downward through G, D, and an A. Finalizing on the root note, on the D, on the 5th fret. Okay, so now here was something that I played in there, which is a good exercise. I ended the line on the 5th. The bass player has been a D. It's a good note. Forms the power chord. That was in the last lesson as well. So then I'm doing some bends, right? I'm going to take you through all these D bends real quick. Fret the first fret. This string here, you're going to bend the second one up, second fret to the third. Then you fret the fourth fret and bend the second one the same way. Your index. Then fret the fifth fret on the G string and bend the fourth fret D string. Then fret the seventh fret with your pinky, index on the fifth fret, and bend that G string. Okay. Fret the ninth fret on the A string, and on the seventh fret G string, just bend the G string, pulling it down. Then, 10, 10, that's high A and B. You're gonna bend up from 9 to 10. I'm sorry, to 11. And here's one here. 12, 12, that's A and D. And then 9, and bend that G string. Here's a little gaggle right here. Do the third finger down a half step while keeping this on the 12th, the pinky. Okay, let's do this one then. One, fret the 14th on the pinky, and bend the B string on the 13th fret, and back home. Okay, that's just 16, and fretting the 15th. Are. You can move those around in keys. Here's a good one. That's really hard to do on the D chord. But up in E. Open E. String. What I'm doing is bending pulling the G string down. And then grabbing the B as well. Whenever I bring it. And I let it go back up. Stuff, but you can use those in the four chords. You're playing. Like a country blues kind of gaggle. Works really good though. Okay, so now let's do this. Thank you. So bend in a minor third.
Thank you.
his licks as the one of the key of D. Everything that you're learning, you can use as the four chord in A, you can use as the one chord in the key of D, right? And then lead to the G, so you can go. Works. It's crazy. So you reconfigure these into different keys. Or we're in A. And back to A. See? It all works together. Stoned. So there we go. See you next time. Number 9. Off to the road this weekend. I'll see you sometime next week. Take care.